McGahee is down for a loss of 2 yards. This is what they had hoped they'd get.
Holding offense, number 73. 10-yard penalty, first down.
That's Marshall Yonda. Remember, Jonathan Ogden out, so Yonda has had to come in and play at the right tackle spot with Ogden out with the toe injury.
Ogden, 6'9", 350, out with this toe. I asked him the other day, isn't it ironic you're so big it's a toe? And he said, of course it is. I used to give people so much grief about toe injuries. A toe, come on, then I got this and it's terrible. He told us, I'm going to go out there and wing it. But Jaws, he did not sound confident that he would last much of this game.
Well, you know, the career of one of the toughest guys in the history of the NFL, Jack Lambert, ended with a toe injury.
Turf toe.
Yeah.
On that hard carpet at Three Rivers in Pittsburgh. McNair to Musa Smith, who scored the touchdown earlier. Smith gets most of the penalty yardage back before Landon Johnson and Delpha O'Neal stop him.
In mythology, of course, you know about the Achilles heel, because it was the only place on Achilles' body that he was vulnerable, the small part of the heel like that. This toe is the Achilles heel of great athletes, right? Huge guys whose career has ended by injuries that you would think they're too big to sustain. Toes.
You are amazing. The depth of your knowledge.
You are in a mythological major at Youngstown State.
Helping for Zed.
Slipped in that day. Smith is the back on second and 11. Oh, well, you know, the Bengals defense led there with Michael Myers coming through to make the stop, the former Bronco. They're playing quite well here tonight.
Once again, it's all about pressure. You're going to see pressure, pressure, pressure. That's what the defense is about right now. Chuck Bresnahan's got this defense flying to the football. They're playing aggressively. None of this bend and break stuff.
And our guy Jason Brown, who pulled and made the nice block, got eaten for lunch by the veteran 10th-year man out of Alabama, Michael Myers. Four receivers, including Heath, the tight end, is out on 3rd and 15. Bengals with 7 covering. Down the sideline for Heath.
Oh!
Big hit by Dexter Jackson to bring it up. Delta O'Neal on the corner coverage. Fourth down.
Sorry for yelling, but I felt that one here.
What a role reversal tonight, in the sense that the Bengals had the defense that everybody said wasn't any good, and they are hitting harder now than Baltimore.
You Boom. Can see the Ravens attacking more down the field. All last season, only 39 balls over 20 yards from the line of scrimmage. That's about 2 a game. Tonight, 3 already.
So Sam Cook to kick it away. Kick of 44, Skylar Green from the 23. A lot of white shirts over there, and he takes a big hit, but he was on the paint. Penalty on Wilcox. Daniel, the tight end, will tack 15 on and take it out to the 47-yard line.
I've waited to call one of these Sam Cook punts that you send me punts. I waited for the third one, and I know it's spelled differently,
right,
but as long as you pronounce it Cook, even K-O-C-H, I'm going that way.
That is how it's pronounced. And the officials are just discussing to make sure he was out of bounds. Then the hit came.
Personal foul, unnecessary roughness. Kicking team, number 83. 15-yard penalty, first down. There was no foul for holding during the kick.
And the big hit by Dan Wilcox from Appalachian State.
Where have we heard that before, Ann Arbor?
I don't know what you're talking about.
What do I control? I don't control the bumps and the bruises, the crowd, or who covers me. I don't control the bounces, the shootout order, or for that matter, what happens outside the rink. There are a lot of things in life I don't control. But then again, there are some things that I do.
Of 2 on week 1 of Monday Night Football, the Arizona Cardinals and the San Francisco 49ers. A couple of teams with youth and expectations. We will see them in San Francisco, Matt Leinart and Alex Smith on Monday Night Football coming up next. There are their numbers. Ron, do you think these guys are ready to make the next step?
Oh, no question about it. They have a great future. They both had a good season under their belt from a year ago, something they can build upon. And what I like is both organizations are building around their quarterback. They're giving them help.
You know, Leinart may have been the number one pick the year Alex Smith was the number one pick. Matt decided to stay at USC.
Come out, right?
Get another championship.
And Tony, we get to watch another game tonight. Isn't that great? We go back to the hotel.
Yeah.
What are rules?
In the 47th.
I'm on the bus, baby. I'll watch it on DirecTV on the bus.
The fullback Jeremy Johnson carries for two. Kelly Gregg and Juan Edwards make the tackle.
You'll be watching the Mythology Channel or something like that on the way back.
You get that one too? I got that on upper tier cable, the Mythology Channel. Health and phys ed, huh? Yeah. You must have been a stud at that.
I graduated.
You say, you claim.
Palmer to Husmanzado. First down, 41, gain of 9. Mikowski made the tackle.
Yeah, Carson's really working the edges of this defense. When he sees the safeties come down, either Landry or Reed, he knows he's got those isolation routes on the outside, doing a terrific job with the throw. They're beating the linebacker. You see Ray Lewis trying to get to the curl area, could not make it. The timing and rhythm was too good on that play by the Bengals offense.
Here's Daniel Coates, their rookie tight end out of BYU, who they like a lot in the passing game as part of this two tight end set with Reggie Kelly. Palmer, Johnson, gain of 13, thrown down by Samari Roll. First down.
Really working the perimeter, the outside edge, the sideline. You'll see it right here. Teachmay Hujmanzada and Chad Johnson. Hujmanzada's going to run the out route on the corner, Chris McAllister. That's going to leave Chad on the safety, DeJuan Landry. That's a matchup that Chad will win. Here, you're going to see the swipe by Bart Scott to try to take away the out route. It's just not going to work. The corner on that side, Samari Roll, is expecting inside help. Bart Scott cannot get out there.
2-minute warning, Bengals driving. We have PTI at halftime on Monday Night Football. So Tony leaves us to prepare.
I'm going to leave it in Jaw's capable hands with your capable hands. I'll see you in a bit.
Once upon a time, there was an armorer's shop. And in the shop, there was a file made of the densest metal, glinting on the floor. A serpent, in the course of his wanderings, came into the armorer's shop. As he glided over the floor, he felt his skin pricked by the file. In a rage, he turned round and tried to dart his fangs into it. But he found that the metal was solid and impenetrable. At this stage, it would be wise to realize that the unyielding metal should be treated with the utmost caution. But the serpent, having had his skin already pricked, flew into a rage and tried to dart his fangs into the metal again.
To 1,000.
The serpent could do no harm, and his fangs bounced harmlessly away.
Oh.
The metal was unyielding. But the serpent, in his fury, decided to tack with all his might. The serpent, having destroyed so much of his own strength, had to give over his wrath. It is useless attacking the insensible, and it is even more foolish to do so at the cost of all your strength.
Halftime show, Chris Berman and Stuart Scott. Chris at our studios, Stu here of the fastest 3 minutes, and Michael Wilbon, Tony Kornheiser, pardon the interruption, live from Paul Brown Stadium here in Cincinnati on the Lexus halftime show. 2-minute warning from the 28.
with a full complement of timeouts. Osmanzada is lit up by Samari Roll. Jaws, these corners have been getting burned a little bit, trying to exact some revenge.
Well, what they're trying to do is give them a little help over the top so they can drive those quick routes to the outside. You'll see the quick flat route by Osmanzada, and Samari Roll said, I'm tired of getting beat. I'm going to beat on somebody else.
I think this is key, Ron, because if they can hold them to a field goal here, for as poorly as the Ravens have played, and as they've been moving the ball down the field, the Bengals, with the three turnovers by Baltimore, to get out of here 12-7 would not be bad.
It might be a moral victory.
Palmer, screen Johnson, little bit of room. What an open field tackle by Roll, a few yards shy of the first down. And here's the XO story of why Cincy's been moving it down the field.
Well, they're attacking the edge of the defense. You see Samari Roll get turned around by Osmanzada. This team attacks down the field to the sideline, looking to work their wide receivers. The strength of the Bengals are their wideouts. Here, just a beautiful route by Chad Johnson, beating Dewan Landry. And Chad, very happy about that touchdown catch. He's on the way to Canton. Doesn't know what year, but he says he's on the way.
11 catches for 132 yards from these two receivers who were together at Oregon State, came into the league about the same time, and their quarterback is on target. Carson Palmer has hit his last 9 throws. Eric Gajcik, the Cincinnati center, was injured on that play. He has been battling a neck injury. Gajcik, a little woozy, is brought off the field. Because of the injury stoppage in the last 2 minutes, the Bengals are forced to use one of their 3 timeouts. They have 2 remaining.
And Mike Gajcik made a great block on Ray Lewis. It was a man-to-man coverage on that screen. So Gajcik went out and blocked Ray Lewis. They were able to get 6 yards on the play.
Alex Stepanovich comes in at center out of Ohio State. He's with the Arizona Cardinals. Has been a 30-start man in his NFL career. And worked a lot with Palmer this week because Gajcik was hurt. No snap problem there. But the third receiver, Tad Perry, who's in because of Chris Henry's suspension, does not hook up. And a field goal attempt for a banged-up place kicker coming up.
Yeah, that's a play that the Bengals must connect on. They got the zone coverage. Tad Perry sat on the hole. Carson threw it a hair to the outside. With Chris Henry out for 8 games, Tad Perry in, you can see the communication just wasn't there.
40-yard attempt for Shane Grab, normally a very accurate kicker, but as has been mentioned, hurt his hip in Atlanta 3 weeks ago in the preseason. Hasn't kicked since then. And a little bit of practice late this week. Another bad snap. Another great job by the punter, Larson, who holds. And Graham on target from 40. The punter, Larson, has done a great job with 2 poor snaps here tonight. Cincinnati 12, Baltimore 7. Well, we've talked about all our rowdy friends joining us on Monday night. We've invited you in the video camera world to send in your submission to show us rowdy friends. Well, here is the first rowdy friends home video of the season.
Uh-oh. Very good.
How about Julia and Ryan from the other side of the Ohio River in Kentucky, big Bengals fans? Well, here's the deal. As fans of your team, look, you know your schedule. You know when your team's a Monday night. We have Washington, Philly next week. The next week, Tennessee, New Orleans. We will upload your videos, ESPN.com, the Monday night surround section. The best videos may, and we emphasize may if they're good, be shown during the Monday night game with your team. So join our ESPN rowdy friends on Monday nights this season.
You'll get about 10,000 from Philly this week, right?
B.J. Sam's got a block, got another one, and Graham, who's afraid to make a tackle because he gets hurt the last couple of tackles, and he is slow to get up after a great return by Sam's to the 41-yard line of Cincinnati. Here's Michelle.
Mike, seems all we've been talking about is injuries. Here's one more. Center Eric Gajcek is questionable after taking a blow to the head. You saw him walk off dizzily. But let's not forget the one we mentioned at the top of the show. Head coach Marvin Lewis on the sidelines on crutches and a cast. Just watching him hobble around the sideline has been painful. He hasn't been able to get from point A to B very quickly. And in quick change or sudden change situations, it's been a real struggle for him. I've been tired just watching, Mike.
Last two preseason games he coached from up in the press box said it was horrible. Musa Smith. Good run again to the 30-yard line, a pickup of 11. So one more time, this former third-round pick, who was one of 11 players in his Georgia career to gain over 2,000 yards, with a big impact. One timeout left, coming up on a half minute. In field goal range. McNair on target. 18-yard line, Derek Mason. They'll preserve the timeout after a gain of 12.
We talked about the strong arm of Carson Palmer. What a great arm and great throw by Steve McNair.
Got his tackle set, just kills the clock, 13 seconds. Josh, you probably got a play or two here before you use the timeout for the field goal attempt. Steve McNair throwing the ball deeper downfield, Ron. 21 yards past the line of scrimmage, pretty good.
Right, and you could see when he throws the ball beyond 21 yards, his quarterback rating is terrific, 115. That's the best in the NFL. However, the Ravens choose not to attack down the field too often, only 39 throws a year ago. Tonight already, three throws over 20 yards down the field from the line of scrimmage.
Because you have one timeout, you don't have to use the sidelines. You've got the whole field at your disposal here.
You want to keep that last timeout in your hip pocket.
McNair throws the out. It is incomplete as Delpit O'Neal goes up to challenge Demetrius Williams. At 6 seconds, you probably have to go field goal, and they will. What a job by O'Neal.
Yeah, Delpit O'Neal, number 24, right here in terrific coverage. He sees the move by Williams. I love the way he undercuts the route. By undercutting the route, it forced the high throw from Steve McNair.
36-yard field goal attempt from Matt Stover, but we get Cincinnati trying to ice one of the most prolific kickers in NFL history by taking a timeout. Matt Stover, as you see, only Mike Vanderjagt still not in the league with anyone after being cut by Bill Parcells in Dallas in the middle of last year. Stover, second in NFL history in field goal accuracy. So meticulous, Ron. He has 16 red notebooks that chronicle every kick he's made in the National Football League going back to his first year in 1991. He is the longest tenured player with this franchise that started really back in the Cleveland days. And we know that the Browns nickname and logo was left back in Cleveland. The Ravens started anew, but Stover came along with them.
Mike, he's a kicker. He's got a lot of free time to take notes and put all those gyrations in his book.
Another lover of kickers, I see, huh? From 36 out of a Sam Cook hole. And a great return by B.J. Sams on the kickoff. 47 yards, helped set up that 36-yard field goal, so Baltimore able to respond, and they're only down two with 2 seconds in period two. Well, you know we have a game coming up with Arizona and San Francisco next Monday night. We go to Philadelphia as the Eagles and Donovan McNabb try to pay. Can somebody catch a punt?
They will work on this this week. I'm sure Andy Reid has probably had some tryouts in Philadelphia today.
We watched it together. Washington, I thought Jason Campbell looked pretty good for Washington in their game against Miami that ended up coming down to a game-winning Sean Sweezum 39-yard field goal. The game ending in overtime with the victory. Three game-winning field goals yesterday. Green Bay and Denver had them as well. And
do those games show the value of an accurate place kicker that could handle pressure? You mentioned three games, you know, one in overtime, two final play of the game.
And I mentioned the one that happened for Denver in Buffalo. And while we have a second, all of us, and the guys will update us at halftime, the entire league sends its thoughts and prayers to the family of Kevin Everett, the Buffalo Bills backup tight end who suffered what his doctors described earlier this evening as a catastrophic, life-threatening injury. The spinal injury suffered on the opening kickoff of the third quarter. And we'll get an update on that coming up here at halftime. Tad Perry, the return to the 31, fumbles the kick. There is no time remaining. We We'll see who comes up with the recovery, but since there's no flag, the recovery's insignificant. The half will come to an end. Cincinnati gets the ball to start the third quarter. The Lexus Halftime Show is next. Halftime score in a very high-energy first half, 12-10 Cincy. Here's Chris.
All right, Michael, thank you very much, and hello.
Kanye West, whose new release will debut tomorrow, release tomorrow, the album Graduation, the song Stronger. The third quarter begins with Tony Kornheiser, Ron Jaworski, Susie Culver, Michelle Tafoya, Mike Tirico. Glad you're back with us in Cincinnati. A 12-10 Bengals lead, and Cincinnati will get the ball first.
Kanye West, any relation to Adam West, Batman? What do you think?
I doubt it.
Skipped a couple of generations, to be honest.
Where do you come up with this stuff?
Oh, come on. You remember Adam West.
Of course
Batman.
I do. Of course I do.
Matt Stover to kick. Tad Perry, the return from a few yards deep. Former UCLA Bruin. Going to get pulled down by Derek Martin at the 22-yard line. And here's Michelle Tafoya.
Well, Mike, Marvin Lewis told me at halftime that even though Carson Palmer was 14 of 21 for 158 yards and a touchdown, he was not happy with the errant throws and passes. He said there were simply too many of them. We'll look at a couple of them now early on. You see Chad Johnson go up high to try to catch. It's a little bit overthrown by Carson Palmer. And then shortly after that, it was T.J. Houshmandzadeh. Couldn't hold on to this one, thrown to his back shoulder. In spite of that, he said he's happy, but he also wants consistency from the rushing game. Just 23 yards, Mike.
They were not able to get anything established on the ground, Michelle, in their 11 first half rush attempts. Rudy Johnson spinning through the hole and into the waiting arm of DeJuan Landry. Let's show you the numbers through 30 minutes.
Oh, look at that.
Mike, Michelle was talking about Carson Palmer missing a couple of throws that Marvin Lewis was not happy. Marvin should have looked at the pass rush. There were people right in front of him that had to throw over the top of. Of course, I'm defending my quarterback, brother.
Well,
you've got to see the whole field.
You defend these elite guys, don't you?
You stand back there, Tony. See what it's like.
Second down, Palmer throwing the deep ball. And coverage on Houshmandzadeh never came close to breaking free. Samari Roll was there defensively. Cincy's lone touchdown.
Oh, this is a beautiful, beautiful play. Well designed. Chad Johnson's touchdown right here. Oh, look at him work. He's got a safety. You get a wide receiver like Chad Johnson on DeJuan Landry, this is what you're going to get. A touchdown, Tony.
And that's one of our new toys, able to trail and see where the player is going to go with his route, whether it's an offensive player,
a
defensive player.
That's nice.
It'll give you a good sense of the ground guy's cover or the route and an idea to be a step ahead of the game and see what's going on. The pass is complete for the first down. Carson Palmer took a shot. Ray Lewis delivered a blow.
Oh, Tab Perry got clocked on that play by Ray Lewis. Within the 5-yard area, a legal hit. Wow. If you're looking at number 52, he just decked number 88, Tab Perry, who was one of the primary receivers.
But by going for the hit, it allowed Coates to have the area vacated. And you see the shot that was applied by Terrell Suggs, who has 40 sacks in his career, 9.5 last year, just didn't get to Carson Palmer in time. So the third down conversion, just the second of the night for Cincinnati, gets them to the 38. Rudy Johnson has the pile pushed back by Suggs, who won't get credit for the tackle. But it will go to Jared Johnson. He's replacing Adelius Thomas. Remember, all four linebackers, including Suggs and Ray Lewis and Bart Scott, and Adelius Thomas went to the Pro Bowl last year. Thomas moving in free agency to New England, one of the big defensive moves of the offseason. So Johnson, a different type of player, now takes that spot.
And Rex Ryan, the defensive coordinator for the Ravens, he believes in 11 versatile football players. And he that gives each of those guys specific responsibilities. And you can see, I'll show you one a little later. I'll get this Haloti Ngata at 340 pounds playing linebacker. Tony, you will love it.
The 34, Palmer's throw, caught a yard shy of the first down by Richie Kelly, the tight end who was Atlanta's second round pick back in 99, caught 21 balls last year.
You mentioned all those Pro Bowl guys on defense. Did I read there's 13 members of this roster who have been to the Pro Bowl?
That's right.
Baltimore. That's a lot.
I might go quick here to not allow substitution by the Ravens to pick up third in a yard with Palmer. The no huddle can do a lot of things. One thing it can do is handcuff a defense that wants to bring heavier personnel on the field.
You know,
well, he talked about, Carson Palmer told us when we said, why do you go no huddle against them? He said to confuse them and to wear out, tire out their big people.
Well, they are doing to the Ravens what the Ravens like to do the most offense, is wrench space in your mind, make you think so you can't react accordingly. Carson Palmer does a great job of manipulating that Ravens secondary.
That time is just to keep the bigger bodies off the field and quickly go for third and one and pick up the first down. You see the Ravens, I feel like they're getting on the other side of the line of scrimmage a little bit more here in the second half. Bart Scott, one of the Pro Bowl linebackers, to play there.
You know, Mike, because Carson Palmer was so effective with the passing game to the outside in the first half, the Ravens have changed their coverage up a little bit. They're now moving their corners down in that bump and run position with the safeties playing over the top. So they're expecting their front seven, three down linemen or four down linemen and three linebackers or four linebackers, depending what they beg to choose on each occasion, to stop the run.
Loss of three, the carry before Rudy Johnson lost 4 yards. He only has 23 yards on 12 attempts tonight. He's only going to get maybe a yard there. And the Baltimore's defense is really making an impact here. It was Suggs and Scott making the play that time.
You might want to call another play than just give it to Rudy Johnson to either go backwards or fall forward for a yard.
Well, you see the chess match right here, and it's all about penetration in the running game. You see Trevor Price just blow that thing up in the backfield and force Rudy Johnson to cut back away from the point of attack.
And of note, Michelle told us before halftime, Eric Gajcik, the center, was banged up and injured. Alex Stepanovich, the backup center, is in there, along with the two guys who played most of the preseason but are the backup tackles, in Scott Kustra and Andrew Whitworth. Pressure on Palmer, who was brought down by Jared Johnson, who we talked about a moment ago, the man replacing Adelius Thomas. So the Ravens defense gets its first sack and its best series of the night.
In every play in that series, there were white jerseys in the Cincinnati backfield. It was almost, you know, Palmer could have turned and handed it off to them, Jaws, right?
Well, the
they
problem
were right
was,
there.
Yeah, and Eric Gajcik needs to identify who the linebacker was, the center. He did not do a good job. He went to his left, or I believe it's now Alex Stepanovich in at center. He, again, it could be the reason why the protection went awry, the fact that Gajcik was not in there, and he blocked left and should have been going right.
Kyle Larson to punt. Pick of 44 yards. B.J. Sams for the 22. A little room to run. And Sams will give Baltimore a good field position at the 39. Their offense turned it over three times in the opening quarter. But the defense is starting to get its sea legs back. And the Ravens have good field position when you come back.
Hey, owners. You know, you can get all your American sports fix daily right here on NASN, your channel for North American sports. Join me and this merry band of journalists as we chew up,
David
spit
Beckham
out all the sports of the day.
Why do you stop freaking matches at noon?
Exclusively on NASN. Hort!
Here he goes.
ESPN's Monday Night Football is brought to you by NikeFootball.com. Leave nothing. DirecTV, For the most sports in HD, you have to get DirecTV, Verizon Wireless, and Miller Lite. For award-winning taste, there's no debate. Miller Lite, good call.
Queen City. Spectacular on this 70-degree night, and we said a very slight chance of rain. Well, if you had slight, you win. Starting to rain lightly. Ravens take over their own 39. And the pass is out of the hands of Mason. It was not ruled an incomplete pass yet. Now it is. Now it is ruled an incompletion. There was no whistle, and Marvin Lewis will look up at the replay screen to see if this is a play he should challenge. Mason shaken up. He's coming off a bad ankle anyway.
Excellent job by Leon Hall right there. Reaches his arm in and rips the ball away. Good coverage, but great ball skills. But sometimes we don't talk enough about that as we talk about defensive backs in the National Football League. Rips it out.
It will be possession and then 1-2 steps, but that is a play they cannot challenge there. So it's just an incompletion, second and 10. And a run for McGahee, gets 3 yards to the 42-yard line. But just joining us past the top of the hour, 7 Eastern start because of our doubleheader. In the early going, it was all Cincinnati. Palmer moving the ball, effectively passing downfield and outside the numbers where he can get to the Ravens. Chad Johnson catching the 39-yard touchdown. That was the much talked about celebration, a faux Hall of Fame jacket. Meantime, the Ravens turned it over 3 times in the opening quarter. All Cincinnati could get out of it was 9 points. The Ravens offense has not looked steady and consistent at any point, but they did put together 1 drive, and it's now a 2-point game. McNair had it come out of his hands in the air. It is caught on the fly by Landon Johnson. Cincinnati, touchdown. A little rain, it's getting damp, but D.U. Williams had his hand around the ball as well. Bengals by 8, 4th turnover of the night.
But D.U. Williams does a terrific job. You will see the pressure. It's coming right there. It's coming from Landon Johnson. There's the pressure. Now, you see D.U. Williams come clean. He whacks McNair with the ball in the air. Landon Johnson makes the interception and takes it to the house. Chuck Bresnahan, the defense coordinator, is dialing up some outstanding blitzes this evening.
Extra point try by Graham is good. Robert Gethers also getting there at the same time. We'll have to get a couple of looks at it to see who knocked it away.
3 turnovers by McNair. Who's got the great defense? Cincinnati's is good tonight. Very good.
Think you have what it takes to get to the top, to take the team all the way? Here's your chance to prove it. Out of the Park Baseball 2007 is one of the most realistic and flexible baseball management games ever. Create an online, fictional, or historical league. Set your lineups and pitching staff. Get rid of that broken down veteran and take a risk on the rookie from your minor leagues. It's in your hands. Out of the Park Baseball 2007. Download a free trial from nasn.com.
The timeout in Cincinnati. 19-10. Robert Gethers, as we looked at it during the timeout, the defensive end comes up with a tip for Marvin Lewis's defense, and Landon Johnson brings it back. Officially changed to a fumble by the official scoring, but we'll see if they review that. BJ Sams from the 1, taken down at the 30. 1 yard line. You mentioned Gathers coming up with the tip, and you know, on the Cincinnati team with Chad Johnson, Rudy Johnson, even Jeremy Johnson, who thought that Landon Johnson would score a touchdown?
Flying under the radar as the 2006 season started, Frank Gore was not the focal point of opposing defenses. But as the 06 season finished, everyone noticed his talent. Amassing over 1,600 yards on the ground, Gore led the NFC in rushing, while his 2,180 combined yards set a new franchise record. The 49ers' best offensive weapon is a player that teams will have to pay attention to.
I'll trade you a Red Sox home jersey and a Rangers t-shirt for that Pirates jacket.
No way! I want that Cardinals hoodie and that Braves away uniform and an item to be named later.
You drive a hard bargain.
Majestic Athletic, the official uniform supplier for all 30 Major League Baseball teams. Available now all over Europe at NASN.com.
A couple of quarterbacks, pretty good ones too, in Brett Favre, who tied the NFL record for wins.